Have you ever wondered why humans are the only species capable of talking? If chimps are so smart, why can't they speak? Hey guys, Tara here for DNews, and if you're like me, then every so often weird thoughts will pop into your head and you won't be able to stop thinking about them until you figure out the answer. This morning, that thought was, why can't chimps speak? Which is great because it turns out there was an article published just today about that very subject. Scientists have discovered the reason behind humans' unique ability to produce and understand speech. And it turns out it may have arisen from a gene mutation over 500,000 years ago. That gene is called Foxp2, and it exists in both humans and chimps. Its connection to language was first discovered in a group of family members who had severe difficulties with speaking and understanding speech, and that family was found to be carrying a mutated version of this gene. Back in 2009, there was a study published in Nature about Foxp2 showing that the human and chimp versions of this gene not only look different, but function differently too. Somewhere around the time humans began developing the capacity for speech, our Foxp2 gene became mutated, and that mutation resulted in different gene targets being switched on or off in human and chimp brains. In that study, scientists genetically engineered mice to express the human form of Foxp2. Mice who were given that mutation learned to run a maze much more quickly than normal mice, meaning their learning capacity was effectively enhanced. Specifically, they developed the ability to turn mindful actions into behavioral routines, which is a necessary learning process for developing language. It hinges on two key types of memories: declarative memory, which is the memory of events and places, and procedural memory, which is needed for routine tasks. In humans, those two types of memories work in conjunction with each other. So when somebody shows us a hand, for example, and says the word hand, we're transforming the experience of hearing that word into an automatic association, meaning our brains now associate the word hand with objects that look and function like hands. And once we learn that association, it's with us forever. That's why when we're performing routine actions, like driving to work every morning, we don't need to consciously think about it as we're doing it. We just do it. That's not really the case with other species, though, and our unique ability to do that is an essential part of how we've come to develop and understand speech. It's crazy to think that a single gene mutation could be responsible for our entire development of language, but what's crazier is that it doesn't completely rule out the possibility that other animals could someday develop speech. Of course, even if they did develop that mutation naturally, it would still take thousands, if not millions, of years to set in, but it does make you wonder what would happen if something like that occurred. Imagine someday being able to communicate with chimps. It's like a weird alternate reality version of Planet of the Apes. Kind of scary to think about. But on the bright side, if it does happen, we'll all be dead by then. And on that topic, I want to remind you guys that I host another show here on Discovery called Anywho, where we recently did an episode about four of the most gruesome unsolved murder cases.
In 1919, a series of murders took place and were blamed on a man calling himself the Axeman, named after the wood cutting tool, not the body spray. But that is also dangerous.
So if you feel like getting grossed out, you can watch that episode over at youtube.com/revision3. And in the meantime, if you guys have any questions, comments, fears about our impending chip overlords, just leave them in the comments below. Otherwise, thanks for watching.